few elements on the periodic table which makes hybrid vehicles, electric vehicles, wind turbines, solar panels, MRI machines, and a number of those clean energy technologies possible. Today, China provides 97% of the world's rare earth materials. Not only do they provide the rare earth material, they also provide the final application. They make the wind turbines. They are now making the battery technologies and the electronics. Rare they aren't. If you took a shovel and dug a hole in your backyard, you'd probably find some rare earths. We have more than enough supply, potentially, today. It became a story. Well, stories bring confusion, especially in a new science area. What is rare, though, is finding them in economic quantities in terms of the concentrations required, because there are rather unique processing technologies to actually extract what you're looking for. Prices have risen over the last several years on rare earths as the new applications were coming into being. And more recently, the Chinese have imposed a number of export quotas on the supply of their rare earths. They wish to improve their own environmental practices. They also have a very large growing demand internally and want to satisfy that domestic demand first. It's not a matter of price, it's a matter of availability. At times, the market has gotten caught up in some of the prices. I think the prices could be absorbed or managed. It is strategic. I think all new technologies and policy directives are to implement green energy technologies, get off of oil and clean up the environment, etc. There have been some political incidences recently with a fishing boat incident in Japan, and China, through administrative or through policy, slowed up the delivery of rare earths. And the Chinese have actually been encouraging that for the last 5 years or so. They have said, we're going to put embargoes, we have our own demand, hurry up and get going. The private sector has been doing the majority of this in terms of organizations like Molycorp, Avalon, Linus Corporation. A number of corporations have recognized this need. The Japanese companies, Toyotas, the Hitachis, recognize that, have been taking the action. Governments have now been rising to the occasion, recognizing, wait, there are broader issues. Strategic trade imbalances, trade embargoes, currency, prices. There's ample resources. This is a relatively small sector, anticipated by 2015 to run about 185,000 tons a year. Not a very large one. And by four or five, maybe half a dozen producers in the West should be ample to drive further technology. This is not copper, this is not diamonds. And its end use, it's not the product itself, it's the value added, it gives, the enabling capabilities it brings to these other technologies. Even if you found a reserve today, it takes 10 to 20 years to bring it into production on a good day.